Now, welcome back, children. In this paragraph, we read that Satyarthi mentions the name of people like Malala. He mentions Kainath, Shazia, right? Why is he mentioning them? He's just giving an example that these girls have taken initiative and they have set an example to fight against violence, fight against fear, extremism, etc. So they are, that means our youth is not at peace now. Now they are coming out of their shells to fight against atrocities, fight against all wrongs. Okay, they're fighting for their rights, right? So he says the solutions are emerging, the solutions are coming up, but he says these solutions cannot be found in the deliberations in conferences alone. Underline, children, deliberations in conferences. Deliberations in conferences refers to the decisions made up in meetings. And prescriptions refer to recommendations. He means to say that though the solutions are coming up, there are solutions coming up for all kinds of problems which exist in the world, but decisions made up in the meeting is not enough. Okay? Recommendations made from a distance is not enough. It is the small group of people who are actually the small organizations, the small group of people, the individuals who are actually suffering. Okay? And it's time to they are actually facing the problems in the life. Therefore, it's time to sort out the problems. Right? We cannot sit and watch. He says, you may ask that, what can one person do? I will recall a story of my childhood. A heavy fire had broken out in the forest. All the animals were running away, including the lion, the king of the forest. Suddenly, he saw a tiny bird rushing towards the fire. He asked the bird, what are you doing? To the lion's surprise, the bird replied, I'm going to extinguish the fire. The lion laughed and said, wow, can you do it just keeping just one drop of water in your beak? The bird was adamant and she said, I am doing my bit. Children, it's a very inspiring story which he narrates from his childhood. Okay, he says that in the forest, what happened? Once a heavy fire had broken out. A forest caught fire. So all the animals started running away, okay, here and there to save their lives, including the king of the jungle, the king of the forest, even the king of the forest, so-called lion, okay, was also running away to save his life. Suddenly, what did he see? He saw a tiny bird rushing towards the fire. And when he questioned her, that when he inquired of her that what she was doing, what she replied, that she was trying to put out, extinguish means put out the fire. At this, lion mockingly laughs and says that with just one drop of water, is it possible for you to extinguish fire, to put out fire? But then bird, she was adamant. Adamant means she was firm on her decision. Okay, she was firm on her decision and she replied that I'm doing my bit, that I'm doing my effort. It's my effort, I'm trying my level best. Okay, so children, what do you learn from this story? Learn that we should not care for people around. There should be someone who would try to take initiative to eradicate the problems, irrespective of any circumstances. Okay, whatever be the circumstances, we should be readily, try to sort out the problem. We should not wait and watch. Right? So this bird had unflinched desire to extinguish the fire. So she did not mind the mocking words of lion. Clear? Right. Now next is, Satyarthi says, Friends, we live in an age of rapid globalization. We are connected through high-speed internet. We exchange our goods and services in one single global market. Thousands of flights every day connect us from one corner to another corner of the globe. But there is one serious disconnect, and that is lack of compassion. So he says that we are living in the age of quick progress, worldwide progress in business operations. Okay, we are connected to high, we are using high speed internet nowadays. We are exchanging goods and services in one single global market through this high speed internet. Okay, we are connected from one corner of the world to another with the help of flights every day. But there's one serious detachment, disconnect. What is that? We lack compassion. We do not have feelings for others. We do not pity others. We do not have any concern for others. Understood? Then he says, let us inculcate and transform this individual's compassion into global compassion. He says, let us come together and try to instill, or let us try to fix an idea in our minds and try to change the individual compassion. Children, transform means change. Individual's compassion refers to selfishness. Okay, he says that we should come out, we should not try to be now selfish in our lives. We should not think about ourselves only, or our people, our family members. Now, out of this, we have to come out of our individual compassion and change it into global compassion. Global compassion means the compassion which should be shown worldwide, apart from our family members, apart from our near and dear ones. Now we should try thinking about the sufferings of the people all around the world, especially children. Okay, so now a collective action is required. He says, let us globalize compassion. So he says, it's time to globalize compassion. It is time to make the compassion worldwide. Clear? Then he quotes the words of Mahatma Gandhi. He says, Mahatma Gandhi said, if we are to teach real peace in this world, we shall have to begin with the children. I humbly add, let us unite the world through compassion for our children. I ask, whose children are they who stitch footballs yet have never played with one? Whose children are they who harvest cocoa yet have never tasted chocolate? Whose children are they who are dying of Ebola? Whose children are they who are kidnapped and held hostage? They are all our children. So here you can see how agitated Satyarthi seems to be. First, he quotes down the words of Mahatma Gandhi. He says that even Mahatma Gandhi has said that if we really want to teach peace in the world, we should start with the children. We should begin with the children. Similarly, we should come together and start the feeling of compassion. Begin the feeling of compassion. Globalize compassion for our children. We should start with our children first. Then he seems to be agitated, a bit angry and annoyed in these lines. He says, the children who are working in the football factory, they are stitching footballs. But do you know, children, the children are working as a laborer in the football factory, but they must not have ever got a chance to play with a single football. There are children who are working in the harvesting cocoa, for cutting cocoa, but which is used to make chocolate, but these children must not have ever tasted chocolate. Okay, there are children who are dying of Ebola. Ebola is an African disease. Still, these children are not cared for. People do not have any concern for such children. There are children who are kidnapped one or the other day. Okay, they are kidnapped in the various corners of the world. So many sufferings are going on. Children are leading a very, very sorrowful life. They are held captive to get someone's demand fulfilled. So whose children are they? He says that they are all our children. Now we should globalize our feelings. Okay, we should not simply think about our own family members. That's what he wants to insist over here, right? So he's trying to waken us up. He's trying to raise our spirits. He's trying to make us, you know, feel that now we should come out of our selfish motives and think for our children who are suffering in the corners of the world.